Jako první, já bych hrozně rád
Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to thank Timote and all organizers for this beautiful place here and for my invitation, and also for organizing conference on the topic of art, because I believe art is a crucial part of education and it makes up the whole package that the man should experience in the life, in the world. Please, then I would like to have another slide.
Umění je jakýmsi prostředkem nebo
the art is
nějakým způsobem
is a kind of
zprostředkovává tu lidskou zkušenost.
Tool
a v tom spočívá právě
in
ta
showing up the experience
and
in this I see the value.
Vždycky, když mluvím o umění,
every time I speak about the art, I always mention American philosopher Nelson Goodman, who says, I quote, or paraphrase,
a to jako způsob objevování,
the
tvorby
art,
a rozšiřování vědí,
we have to take art as seriously as the science in the method of exploring, composing, and developing knowledge. So I believe this definition characterizes current position of the art in this world today. So I will now start with my first example. Please, second slide. Yeah, there is nothing actually on this slide.
However,
my presentation is called Usage of an Educational Drama and also Misuse of this Dramatical Drama, Education Drama. And I will also compare in some details from the position of literature. So the first example is based on my own experience. I am curious a bit how you react to my experience.
Bude to úplně jednoduchý, nic nebude
It is easy, you need nothing.
Jednoduchá věc.
Easy thing, simple thing.
Já řeknu,
I will say,
do
let's move back myšlení. Into the old ages,
já vám
in our mindset.
Nějakou postavu.
And I will tell you a
kolem,
character,
tlesknu,
and as soon as I clap my hand, you will pretend you are that character. Okay, without any kind of thinking about it. So please, please, if you be so kind, stand up. So we are going back to prehistory time, prehistory ages.
Jako první postava.
And the first character is the old bear. Old ancient bear animal.
Výborný, výborný. Můžete
Excellent.
Reagovat, interagovat
you can interact also among yourself.
Děkuju,
thank
děkuju,
you, thank you.
Dál.
Okay, second. The old prehistorian monkey.
Výborný, výborný. Můžete komunikovat
you can communicate, okay, between you.
Děkuju moc.
Thank
děkuju
you, thank you, thank you. You may Díky. Sit down. Thank you very much for your interaction.
Moje první otázka na vás,
My first question now is simple. How did you feel when I told you this task?
Dobře.
Did you feel good?
Nepatřičně.
Well, not comfortable. Why? Because of some physical predisposition,
Děkuju.
It is the monkey, prehistoric monkey. Anyone else? Any kind of response?
Někdo?
vlastně ještě kdyby to bylo medveď, jako zúčastný napsadá, ale jako náhle je to právě medveď, tak mám túžbu narásť a to...
Well, as soon as it was only a bear, it would be easier, but if it was the prehistoric bear, it would be really, I had a like need to be bigger. So you in the back, anyone in the back, if you really wanted to express this, did you feel good? Yes? Thank you, thank you. I had too, like, few information, but I just said, okay, this prehistory, it was all time, so I don't need to have a lot of information about this. Okay, thank you. I just wanted to illustrate how, with the task of a drama, how we use it, how people use it, and it was mentioned it here.
Hrozně málo ve své podstatě informací.
So we had almost no information with that we could work in our mind. We had no information about a prehistorical bear or monkey. So this is one of principles that put art in danger, as if we just use it only on superficial level, and we need it to deeper it, to get into deeper level. It has historical context, all of this.
When,
so, the drama education is defined sometimes as any kind of play. Of course, it is based on art, on drama, but based on historical facts and historical development and current mindset about art, it has shifted. This drama has shifted to, let's call it overlaps to other art fields. I mentioned, for example, math or physics. They are part of science. And when we compare it to drama, educational drama, when we look at it in more details, we see these overlapses. And in this way, I think it is necessary to realize this.
So,
briefly, I will just mention basic historical development. To use drama is not news. It is not new thing, like last 30 years. We may see, of course, Jan Amos Komenský, who used drama in his education, and also Jesuit schools used drama a lot. In Jesuit schools or monasteries, they used art. And it was only... It was only a declamation. When you look in the history, in the drama, they had very special function that could not have been replaceable. Drama was part of presentation to public, either to other students, students to other students,
or
in a function, kind of a promo, because of fundraising. So these tendencies continued in 20th century, when we see the movement of creative drama under the leader Winifred Ward in 1924, and the theater drama is going to help people, help children, yes? Of course, the art can be used in other fields, yes, it is correct. However, there is arising a question, why? Or not why, but in what way it should be done?
To například jakoby v českém prostředí.
In potom souvisí the environment of Czech Republic.
Jako taková,
here are the terms.
Nějakým způsobem velmi ovlivnil 60.
Drama education. We saw it in 60s. 1960s.
Dalo by se říct. Tak ty tendence
these tendencies from the Western Europe and America came this drama education and its different uses. We have terms, slightly different terms, and we started working with different terms of translation. For example, we have in English the word drama education, drama or creative drama, these three terms. But when we take the word education in Czech context, this term education is translated as výchova. That means only education. But in English term, the word education includes also teaching. So it means that it became part of it, but it doesn't have the whole value of it in Czech Republic, in Czech context. Maybe it's only a detail, but this detail I see as important to realize the question, what should be the content of this subject, the subject, the drama education? What should be the content of it? Lately, there are also new terms with specific fields, for example, dramika or vytvarná dramika. We may translate it, for example, dramatic science, art drama. So here comes another question. Is this art alone, or is there necessity to find new terms for slightly different aspects of drama? So now we come to the characteristic of drama education. We will see the Czech context of drama education. The first quotes, Jaroslav Provázník says, I will paraphrase, that drama education is connected with the art, especially with the drama art, because in order to educate, it uses same elements and processes that are typical for theater. Another, the second quote, the essential content of the drama education is a theater. The students are systematically educated in gaining specific abilities and information. In consequence, these acquired abilities develop the students' abilities that may be used outside of the boundaries in their everyday life. Now we come to the term goal. So the first quote I read you, it is kind of pedagogical direction. This direction, pedagogic direction, include theater as a kind of tool to reach educational goals. So it is aimed at the content, but the theater is not the content. The goal is the personal social development of a person. The second direction that I see is kind of art, artistic direction. And the goal is
on
these overlapses. And it is natural for this definition for art. So in every field, for example, in music, in literature, in fine arts, it is very crucial to understand this typical craft, get to know the processes connected with this specific art. So thanks to the theater has these overlapses and it functions in communication very well. We see that it goes beyond the field of theater and we see only that level of communication without the specific content. This is the reason why I did this experiment with you in the beginning of my presentation. Yes, this is a kind of game, some kind of play, but every game has its rules. So when we take any kind of children game that is important, and that characterize everything, when children make up their own games, there is always somebody from children who will make up the rules and others will agree to these rules. It is connected with the safety place. So I who leads a children or drama group, I know how it is important to explain what is the goal, why children should do something. How can I? So I have to guarantee them the goal, how the game will develop. So this was the example. In what way we can use the topic of prehistory age? So suddenly children, it's new topic for them, they do not know anything about it, and they need to create something. And the same thing is for us, we adults, we didn't know anything about prehistory. It is the same when I would ask you, come here and just tell us something or do something. At this moment, chaos appears. Therefore, it is important for us to create clear rules. Now we see process on the left and product on the right. This is the basic question about drama. Process and product. What is more important? One side says process is more important, another side says product is more important. My opinion is both are important. It is the same as in music, as in art, as in math. It is important. We need to go through a process and it leads us to the goal. I will do a parallel to literature and literary education. There is something in common. in majority.
Nedojde ten proces k tomu výsledku, to znamená
many times we do the process but we do not reach to the goal, the goal to present it to others, to listeners. However, it is important to show it to listeners. So these two principles cannot be divided, separated, and must function as one thing. Process, product. Okay, I will now make it a bit shorter, so just move on. Okay, my example number two. We have enough of theory. Let's come to second example. I am not educated in history professionally, but just I will give you background from the position of drama that I have the experience with. So my first question would be, what do you think of when I say Anna Boleyn? Anne Boleyn. Okay, the wife of Henry the Eighth.
Poprava, výborně, ještě další.
Execution.
Co vás napadá?
Okay, what other associations?
Irsko.
Ireland.
Dál.
Okay, some more.
Uh-huh, děkuju, dcera.
Daughter.
U nás v tomto našem kontextu regionu Slovensko-Česko byla považována za velmi zlou ženu, hoci to nebylo to pravda, ale byla jako o něj pojí.
Mm-hmm. Ještě něco? Tak, pojďme na další slide.
Okay, let's move on to another slide.
Jak tady bylo řečeno, Anna Boleynová byla manželkou.
As I mentioned, yes.
Je to velmi
Anna Anne Boleyn was wife of Henry VIII. She was
byla druhou ženou
second wife of Henry the Eighth, and she was the one who actually England separated from Catholic Church, the Pope Church, and the Anglican Church was established. Church of England was established. So I will just mention, yes. She was then executed. I will just read you a short example that I prepared for you based on two books. Karol Erikson a Alison
Bake.
So just please listen. And I would like you to ask you, it will just go consequently to another part. Just take a pen, please, if you may. Take a pen.
Protože ať už v průběhu, nebo pak na konci vám nechám.
So during this time, or I will leave you a bit of time at the end, please just write down, take notes from the text I will read. Your first thoughts, questions, anything you come up with. When you get up, I will come and I will talk with you, and it will be unpleasant for you. With these words, Henry left the bedroom. He wasn't interested whether Anne has problems with abortion, but she really enchanted him. However, he was angry at her because she wanted to be with him. And since that time, Cromwell took place in Anna's life. Henry might have saved Anna, but he didn't.
Dokud byla naživu,
till time she was alive, he was not able to separate from her.
And
there was Anna's father and Anna's brother and other officers. Anna was sued for betrayal.
Pane Kingston, uvrhnete mne do
železné kopky. Are you going to imprison me? Anna asked.
Ne, paní.
No, I will not. You will be in the same part where you waited before you were crowned. Okay, I agree. And then she prayed, Jesus Christ, please help me. And she knelt on the ground and she cried. And then she started laughing. And then she repeated it again. And she thought she felt as she was in some kind of absurd situation. She thought the king is giving her a task. She didn't believe that Henry would execute her. It was said that the queen was sued for betrayal, and she was sued for horrible crimes, and she was not faithful to her husband. Anne's brother
was also
that she kissed her own brother, and she also slept with her brother and other men. There was a long list of bad. She was sued for adultery and betrayal. In May, on the 18th day, 1536, she heard the execution sentence. And she thought, okay, I heard this. And Kingston answered her, you will not feel pain. And Anna responded, I have heard. Yes, I heard that the executioner is very soft, and she laughed. So on 19th on May, she got out from that building and walked, and she saw so many people all around. The majority of people hated her. However, no one shouted at her. No one shouted glory to her. People didn't see that Anna bowed down, and the people saw only the sword, and the executioner cut the head. People held their breath, and the hand of Anna was just float, and then she was lying on the grass.
Zkusme teď udělat ještě jeden mezistupeň.
Now please, we will answer one short question. Who really is Anne Boleyn for you? Who is Anne Boleyn for you? From the personal correspondence of Henry VIII, we also know that when Anne was awaiting the execution, she asked for mercy, but of course Henry never granted it. And I would want you to do a difficult task, because this material should take a longer time and you should get more and more information. But let's try anyways. So, if you could please imagine in what way a person, Anne in particular, somebody who has 24 hours to live before her execution can feel. And I would like you also to try to write one letter for Anne.
Nechte si čas.
Take your time.
Vůbec se nezaměřujte nebo nerozprávajte se tím, jakým způsobem to má vypadat.
Do not think about the form, what genre, what greetings and what style you should use. Just focus on the emotion. Simple. What are your first thoughts?
Začít psát dopis jako Anna Boleynová.
Think you are Anne and write your last letter. To whom do you want to write? To Henry, your husband, who wants to kill you? Who? I am sorry to interrupt you, but because of the time reasons, please try to finish your sentences. And now I would like to ask, would any of you be willing to read your letter? At least a couple of sentences. Please use the microphone.
Asi mi už nezostáva iná možnosť.
I don't think I have any other options than to side the cruelty, than to face it face to face. Dear God, give me strength.
Moja spriamenosť.
To stand straight.
Nech sa ono stane.
The majesty, let that be my choice.
Ešte niekto?
Anyone else? In the life of people, there are many different situations in many different times. I want you to know that your decision is not affecting me and I forgive you. The decision is yours, but I ask one thing of you. Please raise our daughter Elizabeth in such a way so she is a good woman and she does not forget me. Please, I wish you all the kindness you have shown me. Your Anne. Do not forget how we loved each other, and you are the king. Be kind and fair to everyone. If you cannot hope for your love and affection anymore, I hope another takes my place.
Děkuju vám za práci. A já se teď jenom vrátím zpátky k teorii.
And I will now come back to the theory.
A to spočívá v jednoduché věci v tuhle chvíli. Tady ta aktivita.
And it is in one thing.
Měla demonstrovat to, jakým způsobem funguje divadlo.
To show you how theater works.
S problematikou takzvaně metod dramatické výchovy.
And that is about the dramatical education methods that are often used. And if I could continue with the presentation, to move back, yes, one more. That is it. Yes, exactly. So, the methods of the dramatical education as a method is something that you can see here.
And
that is characterized in a way. The term basically is all activities that are not typical for dramatic education. And that is for a simple reason. And that is that for the dramatic education as such, there is only one typical method, and that is acting. But theater as such, because it uses the combination of all genres, uses many different excess and methods which are used in dramatical education as didactic. They use brainstorming, creative writing, and so on in the dramatical education. And it depends just on the students in which way I choose my next steps, because it can be that I have some material, some information about one character, and the artist can work with it, or I can take step in another direction and will start painting and create a story. And that is also in a way which I wanted to show you in a simplified way to share this knowledge. And this one? This one, yes, thank you. Because with my work it is very important in work with children, in theater or in any game, it's very important to be specific. To be very specific in the first and second example, where I wanted to show you in the second example, in the small steps which you would make your task easier and make it more specific in a general way about the set topic where I want to continue. And that is all. Thank you.